Hi, this is Matt Heaton, and we're going to talk a little bit about reel rhythm on the guitar. So, a reel is, you got two big groups of four. Chuck, 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 chuck. Okay? It's easiest to think of it as kind of like a train. Chuck, 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 chuck. Okay? So you're going nice and light. The thing you want to avoid is you don't want to do a boom chuck. You don't want to go boom chuck, boom chuck, boom chuck, boom chuck, boom chuck, boom chuck. Right? You want to keep it kind of smooth. Chuck, 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 chuck. And then when you're hearing a reel, it's not just a steady stream of notes. There's a lift. There's a backbeat. Like yum tappa ti pa taka ti ka taka ti ka taka dum tappa ti pa tappa ti dum tappa ti pa taka dum taka ti ka taka ti ka ding. Right there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Pa 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 pa. Which you can bring out. So if I slow that down, it's like if I'm counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, it's kind of on the third down, up, down, up, down. Now, some folks have trouble getting things up to speed. They can do it all right slowly, but then once you get going at like a session tempo or dance tempo, it's a little tricky. So here's a really 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 nice trick for that. If you start out with a speed that is maybe a little challenging for you, like ducka 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 ducka, okay? But then what we're going to do is we're going to alternate between doing just down strokes and then filling it in. So dum 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 dum, 1, 2, here we go. Tucka 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 tucka, 3, 4, 1, 2, now back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And switch again. Tucka 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 tucka. Okay. So we kinda alternate between the downstrokes where your hand gets a chance to rest. But you're still playing the same speed, right? You're just not filling it all in. And then the two ways you can go with that are you can either speed the whole mess up, or you can decrease the interval. So you can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, But every time you go back to those downstrokes, let your hand rest a little bit, okay? Because the way you play fast is by staying relaxed, and the way you stay relaxed is by essentially taking small breaks whenever you can. And when you get really good at it, your hand is sort of taking a micro break between each stroke, because you're not really using, your muscles aren't engaged all the time. You know, like once you sort of initiate the motion, it goes on its own, and you can actually kind of not collect tension through that whole thing. So when you're playing reels, just, you know, if you are playing in a session and you're going, and you're starting like, oh, my hand is so sore, you can kind of, you know, keep the rhythm going. You know, it's possible to do it in sort of a musical way that where you can take that little break that you need and not sound like you're giving up. So reels, again, basically you got your foot's tapping, thump, 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 thump. You got groups of four, dupa 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 dupa, and you kind of keep it smooth. Then you add in a little backbeat, lift, and for building speed and relaxation, do alternating sets between just downstrokes and then filled in with the eighth notes. So hope that helps, and enjoy your guitar playing.